Hi everyone, how y'all doing today? I hope things are moving smoothly. I welcome you all to my tutorial for today. So for today's tutorial, we're going to be making a box pleated skirt, and I have here 3 yards of Ankara fabric. That's what we're going to be using for today's tutorial. To my existing subscribers, thank you so very much. To passers-by, thank you as well. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your likes. Thank you for stopping by. And if you happen to be new, this is the Needle Woman. Feel free to hit the red icon to subscribe. And also touch the notification bell so that whenever I upload, you get notifications. So let's just move to the business of today. The measurement you are going to be needing for this tutorial is just the waist measurement and the length of skirt. Now for the length of my skirt is going to be 47. And I'll be adding a band of about 3 inches. So I'm going to be taking away 3 inches from my length of skirt. So instead of cutting 47, I'll now have 44. I hope that is clear enough. Alright, let's go. Alright, so out of my 3 yards, which is this, I removed this. This is about 6.5 inches. When on full, 3/4 inches. This is for the band. Okay, so I'll also go ahead and cut this interlining. I'll use it to line this band first of all. This is what I mean. Okay, of course you should know that the measurement, as in the circumference, should be the circumference of your waistline. Alright, so I'm now going to use my iron to glue it in between the band like so. So you should have something like this. Okay, I'll use my iron on it. So right now I'm gluing it, as you can see. Okay. Okay, now my waist is 37 inches and I have here 40 inches. So the extra few inches are for my zip allowance. Alright. All I will do now is to just start to pleat this skirt, okay? The remaining part of the 3 yards, that's this one. Of course, we know the length of Ankara fabric is 35, okay? And I said my length is, sorry, is 45. And I said the length of my skirt is 47. But because of this band, which I took away from the length of my skirt, I now have 44, okay? So the 1 inch remaining is going to be for the folding allowance. All right. time, all I need to do is just to start to plead. But before then, I'll have to notch my exact waist measurement, which is 37. 37. All right, so this here now is my exact waist measurement. All right, and then here we go. We start this way, okay. The first pleat is going to be very close to my actual waist measurement, like this. So that by the time I do this and do the other one at this end and the zip comes in, it will kiss on its own, okay? So this is one. You just have to decide or determine the space from one pleat to the other. There is no rule here. You decide on how many inches you are giving from one pleat to the other. Okay. So for the distance between one pleat and the other, I used 4 inches. I hope you see it. I already measured and marked all of them out. So I'll just start my pleat. This way. Remember, this is the actual waist measurement of mine, okay? So I'll start this way. You also decide, for me, each of the pleats should be about 3 inches. That's 1.5 on each side. Okay. So you continue this way until you have your skirt covered over the band. If you have a tinier waist, it means it's going to be fuller if you are still using the 3 yards I used. Okay, so I will just continue doing it. So now I've done the pleats. I hope you see it. The box pleat. And I made sure they are evenly distributed. Looking at it, you should see that they have the same measurement. Okay, so I'll just go straight to the machine and quickly run my stitch at this waistline. Okay, I'll go to the machine and just hold it together. So now I've stitched it together, as you can see. This is not supposed to take much of your time. The next thing to do is to mark the position of your zip and then close the side. That is if you are leaving the zip at the side. You can choose to leave it at the side. You can choose to leave it at the back. Okay.
So now for my zip, I'm going to be taking about 9 inches. Okay. And then remember, a zip is going to fit in here and here. Okay. So placing it this way, I'll just close it up from this 9 inches down, and then insert the zip and fold the hemline. So I'll go to the machine. First of all, close up this end, insert the zip, and then fold the hemline, and that will be all. Okay, so this is what we have. Check out the back also. I'll just go ahead and give it a very nice and long press. Okay. I hope you see this zipper area. You see, the two of them are now kissing each other. I hope you see that. I need to pull it out so that you see it very, very well. Okay. Now this is the zipper area. I hope you are seeing the two pleats. It is just similar to each and every other pleat at this waist line. Okay, the only difference is that the zip divided the two pleats. Okay, this way, this place is not forced, you know, to lap with the bum area. Okay, it fits very, very well. I hope you see it perfectly. All right. Thank you, beautiful people, for watching till the end. I really, really appreciate all of you. If you happen to be new to this channel, feel free to hit the red icon to subscribe and also touch the notification bell. Okay? Until we meet in my next tutorial, please stay safe, take very good care of yourself, and determine in your heart to work very hard this 2020. Take care of yourself and bye.